You've all seen the headlines, solar panels catch roof on fire. So we can see why you might be concerned about the fire risks associated with solar panels. But should you be concerned? After watching this video, you'll get our expert breakdown on the fire risks associated with solar energy and how to reduce those risks. Rick, let's talk about whether people should be worried about solar panels catching on fire. First off, are solar panels flammable?
Well, I have to be honest, Warren, I've never seen a solar panel spontaneously combust.
Okay.
So if you think about it, a solar panel is made of an aluminum frame, a glass front sheet, crystalline silica, you know, inside, the back sheet's a plastic. So there's nothing inherently risky about a solar panel. Modern solar panels also have what are called bypass diodes. One cause of a potential heat that would cause a fire on a roof is that if a section of a solar panel is blocked by dust, debris, or you know any kind of obstacles, it can create a heat in that spot on the solar panel. And the bypass diodes are designed to allow power to bypass that part of the panel when the power flow is blocked, so that we don't get the hot spots on panels. So modern panels have bypass diodes. They're not inherently dangerous from a fire perspective.
So other than the older panels that maybe don't have those bypass diodes, what causes solar rooftop fires?
Well, again, I want to be cautious, Warren, you know, because rooftop fires from solar is pretty unusual.
Yeah.
What could cause it, for example, if an installer doesn't use properly rated connectors,
okay.
They're called PV connectors. The National Electric Code requires us to use PV connectors that are what are called listed or designed to be used together, which typically are connectors from the same manufacturer. So you want to make sure that your installer adheres to that National Electric Code requirement.
Yeah.
One major supplier of connectors has found that up to 5% of connector failures has been due to improperly rated connectors being connected to each other. So make sure you use the listed connectors. Make sure that your installer manages the wires on the PV panels. There's wires from every panel that connect panel to panel and the panels back to your inverter. They need to be properly restrained with the proper types of stainless steel clips to the panel so they aren't dragging on the roof.
Yep.
You don't want the wire rubbing against the rough asphalt shingle, for example, and then removing the insulation and perhaps touching a metal object and arcing, because that can certainly cause a fire.
Sure.
Power surges and other lightning related events, I've not seen cases where those have been contributors to an eventual fire. The other thing I'll mention is that when your panels are installed on the roof, if you live in like a wooded area where there's lots of leaves or debris that gets on the roof, I'd strongly encourage you to ask your installer to install what's called critter guard. It's basically a mesh that provides a barrier between the bottom of the solar panels and the roof so that you know rodents can't build a nest underneath there, because if there's a nest, then you have leaves and other flammable materials kind of building up under your array. And if there was a hot spot or something like that, then you've got ignitable materials underneath there that you don't want to have there.
So that's a preventative measure.
Definitely preventative measure. Yeah.
Can solar panels catch fire in extreme heat?
I guess I'd just say no.
Okay. Yeah.
Please, you know, I certainly appreciate the concern, but if you think about it, you know, there are solar farms that have been installed in desert regions.
Sure.
And not just desert regions in the United States. I mean, desert regions throughout the world. There's no cases where a panel itself just got too hot and caught on fire.
So how can somebody reduce their risk from a fire?
That's a great question to ask. The first thing I would say is make sure that your installer uses properly listed equipment,
yep,
like connectors, like we talked about. Make sure that they use good workmanship methods when they attach the wires to the frames to keep them off the roof and away from rubbing each other. I would certainly encourage have your installer or find a competent service company. I'd have someone come out once a year to check my system or get up there yourself. Is there debris collecting underneath the panels, things like that, and keep it clean from that. And I'd keep up with just regular maintenance. Have someone check my system on a professional basis to make sure there's nothing else that might generate heat that could cause something to ignite and catch on fire.
Yeah, makes sense. Will a fire company put out a fire with solar panels on the roof?
That will depend on locality.
Yeah.
Some fire companies who have no training, they kind of view it as a black box. They won't go up there. Solar panels, current modern systems are designed so that the firefighter can go to one location. It's called rapid shutdown. They can turn off the output of the solar panels right at the panel. That reduces the risk to the firefighter. They should be able to go up on the roof. They should try to avoid the panels if they need to vent the structure. Typically, there's panels only on one plane of the roof, so they can always vent the structure on the opposite plane. We've actually done training with local fire companies to help them be aware of how to turn the systems off. So, you know, if you're concerned, I would contact your local fire company. And if the answer is, we don't know what to do, and if it's Paradise Energy Solutions, you can certainly reach out to us or reach out to your installer and just say, would you mind talking to my local fire company?
Yeah, great idea. And then finally, Rick, should you include your solar system on your insurance policy?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You should, you know, when you're, it's a big investment. It's probably one of the biggest investments you're going to make besides buying your home.
Right.
Or whatever property you're putting the system on. Please talk to your broker, get it insured. I have had to deal with a couple of clients who did not do so, and then there was damage from extremely rare weather events,
sure,
and it wasn't covered by insurance, and that's disappointing to see.
Yeah, that's great information. Thank you, Rick, for helping answer these questions.
You're welcome. My pleasure.
Yeah, that concludes our video, and if you found this helpful, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay informed on all things solar. Thanks for watching.